So display advertising, we've looked at kind of what search is, we've looked at Google Shopping and how important that is. This is a market that has changed massively within the last even 6 to 8 months. We used to do, the vast majority of what we would have done previously was the text ads that we looked at the start. We're moving more and more into this stuff. The reason being, it's much more targeted. It used to be a case, somebody said yesterday, nobody did that stuff because you couldn't really target it. You just kind of picked a website and put an ad on it. You didn't know who saw it, if anybody saw it, if they were interested in your product or anything like that. So you'll see up here, display advertising is a simple, cost-effective way to advertise to millions of people on quality pages, topics, whatever it's going to be. So the important thing with this is the Google Display Network, which isn't Google itself. It's basically an amalgamation of websites that Google have agreements with, reaches 92% of internet users. So that's more straight away than the percentage of people that are using Google. Remember earlier on we said it's about 88.38%. So the Google Display Network can reach more people than google.com.co.uk.ie, whatever it's going to be itself. 99% of Google's top performing 1,000 clients run on the Display Network. So it's not a coincidence. It works for these people, and these are people spending millions. So it's a really, really good thing. Great stat for businesses. 35% of people who have seen a display ad will later search for that business. Has anybody seen the movie Focus? New Will Smith one? No? Brilliant. So the next 5 minutes, my story is wasted. The whole point behind this is, and if anybody had have seen Focus, it would have been a lot better. It's kind of subliminal idea. You know, if you see an ad for something in the background, whenever you see it again or you need the service, it's kind of, there's more of an awareness of it. You know, you're familiar with it. And familiarity at the end of the day will be much warmer to go towards. Say, especially in Northern Ireland, we hate stuff we don't know. You know, we're very cautious about, you know, clicking on websites that we maybe don't recognize or whatever it's going to be. So using display to get in front of people in a kind of a, it's not entirely subliminal kind of David Blaney kind of stuff, but it plants a seed with people where you can build on the recognition after that. Some of the top earning sites through the Google Display Network would be the likes of the business site, Business Insider. Then you have that absolute virus, Paris Hilton. And the likes of the tech blog, Mashable. Now, what it means by the top earning sites, these sites all allow Google to place advertisements on their websites, and they then get paid a percentage of what of the revenue that Google gets from people clicking on them. So that's how they end up being top earning. You do need to have a powerful amount of traffic going through your website in order to make this point, to have any point whatsoever, so it's not really for everybody. So, just for example, this is Used Cars NI. And you'll see a display ad here for Charles Hurst and another one down the side for, what have we got, SERE, Charles Hurst, and Charles Hurst reduced stock. So the reason that these ads are placed on there is because they're to do with cars and it's on a car website. Just makes sense. So there's lots of different ways that you can actually target these things, but what we'll look at first is how you actually use or why you would use it. It's great for getting your business found. You choose where your ads are going to appear. So you don't just kind of go to Google, right, we are a retail shop, here's our ads, good luck, thanks very much. We'll just sit back and count our millions later on. You're going to Google and saying, right, based on certain criteria, I want my ads to appear here, 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 not over there, only over here, on that, that sort of thing. So you can engage with your users using different formats such as text, just the wee text ads we've seen, video or rich media. You know the HTML5 flash ads that kind of move about and do all funky things? If you imagine one of those or a video on a static website that's not moving about or doing anything else, they stand out really well. And they can show your business off pretty smartly as well. And each month, the Display Network serves billions of ad impressions. So it shows ads billions of times across the globe, which is really, really good. So why would you use display over search? Generally, we would try to use the two of them in correlation with each other. But just to give you an idea, search ads are triggered by a proactive search input by the user. So I go on and type in Plumber Belfast. I then see search ads for plumbers in Belfast. The thing about that is the user is actively seeking the product. So you'll generally find a click on a text ad is dearer than a click on a display ad because they're going out for two different means. Display ads are triggered when they match a relevant page content or are specifically targeted by the advertiser. So this isn't the user going out and saying, show me an ad for this. This is the advertiser trying to put themselves in front of the user based on certain criteria. So users are visiting pages that relate to their needs, interests, profile, but they're not actively looking for ads. Who does? You know, we don't drive up and down the Ormer Road thinking, I really want to see an ad for Coke, whereas, you know, you don't do that. It falls along the same sort of idea, apart from being online. So different types of display ads you can have. The wee text ads, you can have lovely video ads, mobile ads, image ads, But the important thing about all of these is you're getting in front of a potential client at a time when they're not probably defensive. Some of us have said, although it's now starting to come out that we all do click ads, which is great, some of us have said we don't click on them. These things are brilliant because people aren't expecting to be sold anything at this stage. It's very gentle, it's in the background. If they click on it, that's brilliant. If they don't, it's no real odds. We're still getting the brand exposure.